Welcome back, everybody, for another deep dive into the Deep Space Divorce Saga. This time we're looking at Chapter 5, Massive Action. And things get going pretty quickly here. Last time we left off, John was at a low point, back at his mom's place, trying to figure out what to do next.
Yeah, it's a familiar spot to be in. After a big life change like that, you feel lost. You need to pick up the pieces. But there's also a glimmer of hope for what the future holds.
Right, and that hope is really at the core of what John calls his massive action plan. He decides to tackle things in three parts. First, secure a fuel source for income, then find himself a new rocket ship, which means a new home, and finally put the entire plan into action.
You know, it sounds pretty straightforward when you put it like that, but each of those things is a huge challenge for someone in John's separation. What's interesting to me is how he approaches it all. He doesn't just jump in randomly. He's got a clear strategy, a framework to work with.
Yeah, he's really methodical, which you don't always see.
Yeah.
He's working hard, studying, even going to the gym. And I get this part maybe a lot. He's trying online dating, all while living at his mom's.
Oh, wow. That really adds a whole other dimension to things, doesn't it? I mean, on one hand, he's driven to get his life back on track, but he's also got this vulnerability, this need for connection. It reminds us that even when we're taking massive action, we're still human.
Totally. And it's not all smooth sailing either. He talks about some job interviews that didn't go his way, and a relationship that just fizzled out.
Yeah.
It's a reality check for all of us.
Definitely. It highlights how, even with the best plans, and all the hard work in the world, setbacks are gonna happen. And this is where I think we see John's resilience come through. He doesn't let these things get him down. He sees them as opportunities to learn, to adjust his approach. It's a really valuable mindset for anyone, whether you're going through a divorce or any other major life transition.
And it seems like those lessons paid off because he ends up landing a 100-hour consulting contract, which gave him a much needed financial boost. But there's a detail here that really stuck with me. He mentions that it allowed him to buy Christmas presents for his kids. It really shows you what's driving him. It's not just about getting back on his feet. It's about being a good dad, providing for his family.
It's really powerful. It shows how our personal goals are often tied to our responsibilities to others. His success here isn't just about him. It has a ripple effect on his whole family.
Yeah, and I think this contract was a turning point for him, not just financially, but mentally as well. He talks about deciding to put romantic relationships on hold and really focus on his work. What's interesting is he finds a sense of peace in that decision, even though he knows the contract is only temporary.
That's curious, isn't it?
Yeah.
Do you think that peace came from having a clear goal to focus on? Or was it something more? Like, he realized he needed to take care of himself first before trying to connect with someone else.
That's a good question. I think it might be a bit of both. Maybe it's about accepting what he can control, which in this case is his effort and dedication to his work. And that sense of control brings him some peace.
That makes sense. It reminds us how important self-care is, especially during times of transition. When everything feels uncertain, finding something stable to focus on can be incredibly grounding.
Couldn't agree more. And speaking of things falling into place, John gets a full-time job offer close to his old neighborhood. Perfect cultural fit. It's like the universe was rewarding him for all his hard work.
Absolutely. But it's important to remember that this wasn't just luck. John had been putting in the effort, honing his skills, networking, so when the right opportunity came along, he was ready for it.
And it's amazing how fast things change when you're in the right mindset, you know, ready to grab that opportunity.
It's like he shifted into high gear or something. Within a week, he found a new place and even rejoined his old tennis club.
Seriously, like a complete 180. But you know what? Even with all that going on, he still took time to look back at what went wrong in his marriage.
That's so important, though, isn't it? That willingness to reflect, even when it's tough, it shows real growth.
Yeah, he talks about the financial stress they were under, different expectations they had, and how communication just broke down.
Yeah, it makes you think about our own lives, right? Like, what parts of John's story resonate with you? What feels familiar?
Definitely. I think even though his situation is unique, those themes of, you know, relationships, expectations, communication, those are universal.
Exactly. And as he's rebuilding, there's one part he's keeping pretty quiet about a new love interest.
Oh, yeah. He mentions a co-pilot situation, but doesn't give us much detail.
It sounds like he's happy moving on, but also wants to keep things private, at least for now.
It makes you wonder if maybe he's being more careful this time around.
maybe learning from the past, being more aware of those potential red flags.
Right. Or maybe he just realizes the importance of taking things slow, letting the relationship unfold naturally.
It definitely adds another layer of intrigue to his story and keeps us all guessing.
Speaking of things keeping us on the edge of our seats, the next chapter is called We Almost Lost the Ship.
That doesn't sound too promising.
So even with all the positive steps John's taken, it seems like there are still some rough waters ahead.
Life rarely goes according to plan, right?
This chapter really highlighted the power of taking action even when it's hard and facing those setbacks head on.
And celebrating the wins too, of course.
What stood out to me was how much focusing on what he could control made a difference for John.
It's a good reminder for everyone listening, I think.
Even when things feel totally chaotic, taking charge of your own actions and choices can really turn things around.
Absolutely. John's story is such a testament to that even after a major setback, you can always rebuild, reorient, and find a new path forward.
Yeah, it's like even when you feel like you've been totally knocked down, there's still a way to get back up even stronger.
And John is proof of that.
So as we wrap up this chapter of the Deep Space Divorce Saga, what are the main things you hope people take away from it?
I think the biggest one is that you have to take action, even when it feels scary. John didn't just sit around feeling sorry for himself. He made a plan and got to work one step at a time.
Right. And when things didn't work out, he didn't give up. He just kept going and adjusting. And in the end, he found his way to a much better place. It's like a lesson in resilience,
you know? Exactly. And he also took the time to really think about what went wrong, to learn from those experiences and use that knowledge to make better decisions in the future.
Yeah, that self-reflection piece. That's so important for growth in any area of life.
Absolutely. And as we get ready to move on to the next chapter, which remember is called We Almost Lost the Ship, I want to leave our listeners with a question. What can you do today to take massive action in your own life? What goals are you ready to chase after?
Stay tuned to find out what happens next time when we return for Chapter 6 of the Deep Space Divorce Saga.